Hello and good morning. It is a wonderful day here in Illinois, other than super noisy, because we're right along the Interstate 57, I think it is. Anyway, we're loaded up again. We're going to get the heck out of here. It's very cold up in Wyoming, but here it's 55 degrees Fahrenheit. We're all loaded up, waiting for my wife, and we're hitting the road, heading south to Nashville today. All right, if you're a car freak and love to have a clean car, look away now. I'll tell you, because this car is absolutely filthy. So I'm going to show you something that a lot of people just will cringe. All right, you ready? Here's my finger. And see that grit? Watch. Oh, no. Don't worry. It's got paint protection film on it. Any scratches, once they warm up, will disappear. And it'll be as shiny as it was brand new. Yeah, there's proof. There's where all that dirt went. Look at that. Ooh-wee. Uh-huh. If you remember from yesterday's video, we pulled into the hotel at 85. We used 3% overnight for the Sentry mode. It says one event. I could look, but I'm not going to worry about it. All right, I think we're ready to roll. Here's what we do. When you get in your car in the morning, you set your destination. So we're gonna go ahead and set it for Nashville, Tennessee, okay? And there's a bunch of them, that's fine. We'll just pick one there, okay? It calculates our stop based upon the energy that's in the car. As you can see, it's going to want us to stop in Kutawa, Kentucky. And we arrive there at 9:24 a.m. with 33% energy. All right, 129 miles to go. Let's go. Today's trip meter is set, thanks to Greg. He remembered. We are at zero, and so far we've driven 5,204 miles. Look at that, 2.2 megawatts hours of energy used, and not one bit of emission from the car. Yeah, we're up on Interstate 57 here now, 80% in the battery. Arrival showing 34% at Kutawa, which is great. And that'll give us a little quick charge and head on to Nashville. We just transitioned to Interstate 24 now. And we're just commenting the road surface is very rough, and you can hear it. It's just not very good shape here. Anyway, we have 75 miles to Kutawa Supercharger here. Just going through construction here on autopilot. I'll tell you, there's two seasons up here in Illinois, winter and road construction. And there's tons of projects all over the place. I get the question all the time here with autopilot, and people go, oh, well, does your autopilot work in construction? Well, I don't know. Take a look yourself. We're set here behind these other cars. This is construction. It'll get narrower up here, and we'll see. I'll go ahead and it looks like it's going to be a while. They moved the barriers over to the right. The car visually sees where every barrier is, right? So if you look, you can actually see it sees everyone, even the one that's out of place. You see that? And we're just driving along here. I keep the thing happy with my hand on the wheel, but I'm not steering. As you know, with the autopilot, it really, you see, I'm wiggling it now, and it's still in autopilot. You have to give it more rotational torque to break the autopilot. See, now I wiggle a little bit, and it's happy. So we continue to drive through the construction. And I'll be back when they slim up the barriers, because this is a no-brainer for autopilot. route of the construction. It was a weird construction site. It was improperly marked, but it's okay. Looks like the trees have just about had it here. There's still leaves, but they've all turned, and I think they're just hanging on for dear life here now. Let's do an energy check. 46 in the battery. Our arrival percentage is showing 28% at Cutawa. So we'll be there in 40 minutes. We'll get some juice and head on to Nashville. I knew it, I knew it. Clark Kent lives here. I think we're just leaving Illinois. I think this is the Ohio River. Yep, Ohio River. And a lot of big barges and things. If we take a look over here, you can see it's gigantic. Anyway, this is a double span. It allows all of the shipping to go underneath. And if I'm not mistaken, this may be the state line between Illinois and Kentucky. We'll find out. I think it is. Another span. Of course, I think it's riveted. Yep. They quit using rivets some time ago. This has been here a while. There you go. Two spans. Oh yeah. We drove on autopilot to get across the Ohio River. Oh, looky there. There's our sign. Welcome to Kentucky. We have found the rain. Yes, sirree. And does autopilot work in the rain? Of course it works in the rain. The only time I've ever seen it not work is when you couldn't see more than 40 or 50 feet. It slowed down, but it continued to work. Anyway, this is light rain. It's not a big deal, but we're continuing on autopilot. Southbound, Interstate 24. Little energy check. 37 in the battery, and our predicted arrival is 28%. Just about ready to go over the Tennessee River, and yes, we're on autopilot. Another riveted bridge. It flows in. I think all these flow into the Mississippi. Not sure. There we go. AP over the Tennessee River. We're just about ready to get off Interstate 24 for Cutawa. Cutawa is here, supercharger that is. And we get off here.
Exit 40 on the right.
And there's Cutawa.
In 1,000 feet, turn right onto US Highway 62 West.
Now, if you look close, you can see the supercharger. Looky there, there's nobody there. How about that? Look at
it. Now turn right onto US Highway 62 West.
All right, so here we are. We're here at Cutawa. Cutawa Supercharger is behind the hotel here. It's down from a gas station where you can use the restroom. It's an 8-stall 150, and I see somebody's put trash cans here, which was an excellent idea. We're going to go into 4 Bravo. Actually, I take that back. We're going to do a little tactics here. Instead of going into 4 Bravo, we're going to go into 4 Alpha. The chance of somebody coming in on the end will be slim, and maybe we won't get doubled up here during the time we're here. Put the dots there right where you want them, right between the two lines, and hold them there as you back up, and guess what? You bash the trash can. Just arrived with 27%, which was the predicted, I think, was 28, but it probably changed. All right, we're going to charge up. I got to set the destination to Nashville. I think it's there already. It is. 15 minutes to go. Doesn't take long to charge up here. We're going to charge a little extra because we got to bum around in Nashville before we go to our destination. let's go get charged. Yes, this is a 150 kilowatt 8-stall supercharger here in Katawa. And I just noticed something. Kind of a neat sign, Tesla parking only. It's cool. But I just noticed this. Check it out. If you have a Leaf or something like that, you can plug in here. And there's even a light to show you what's going on. How about that? There's a Leaf charging station here. Your choice to use the restroom here at Katawa is BP. Nice place, a lot of stuff. And then right here on the corner is, I don't know, it's kind of a no-name gas station. Oh no, it does say Exxon on it, and they have a little store inside as well. A couple places to stay. There's a Hampton Inn right next to the supercharger. There's some kind of a diner here. I don't know if it's ever been open. Maybe it is. But anyway, across the street, if you want to go across the highway, there's stuff over there. But there's things to do and eat here, I suppose. There's also a Western Grill, make that Southwest Grill, right next to the supercharger here. So pick your poison. Yeah, the Model X is handsomely decorated with Wyoming dirt. We just got back to the car. Car's reporting 5 minutes until we can continue our trip now. We have enough energy to get there. Of course, 29% on arrival. I was sending an email, so we charged a little extra. All right, I think we're good to go. We've got 73% here in the battery and 28 on arrival, so or make that 29. Let's go. We just had a discussion, Greg, Sue, and I, about using cruise control. We came up on a slower car driving in the left-hand lane. He was doing about 72 at 75 here. And he just wanted to drive in the left lane. And when he got near another vehicle, he'd slow down. And when he got away from that vehicle, he would speed up. And it was kind of weird. Anyway, so we passed him. And he's not apparently using cruise control. And so the object was, is I use autopilot all the time. It's like cruise control. It steers the car for me, though, keeps my distance to the vehicle in front, and I just tool on down the road, and the car is happy as pie. Now, what stress does the driver have? Well, it's pretty simple. It's kind of like an airline pilot. They set the autopilot in an airline to go a certain heading and altitude, and the airline pilot just monitors the controls to make sure that everything is going the way it's supposed to. Driving a Tesla on autopilot, it's very much like that. I make sure that there is no debris in the road up front. I make sure that the car is operating properly. No animals are going to jump out in front of me. And as far as I'm concerned, it stays in the lane and keeps its distance. If somebody pulls in front of me, it'll slow down and keep its distance, like this guy is going to do right here, maybe. Anyway, I don't worry about it, because even though he pulls within 2.5 car lengths of me, the car just will adjust my speed and be as happy as pie driving along here. I'm not stressed. I simply take my left hand, grab the wheel, and just drive like that. It keeps the car happy knowing that my hand is on the wheel. So use the autopilot. Use your cruise control. It is a wonderful feature. All right, let's have a look around here in Kentucky. All right, let's have a autopilot tutorial, show you how easy it is to use. Currently on autopilot, I'm gonna go ahead and shut it off by pushing the stalk forward. There, now we're off autopilot. I have the speed set for 75. I take the autopilot stalk and I pull it back once. and it turns on cruise control. And that just is a blue circle around the current speed, whatever I was going. Now, to activate autopilot is just as easy. You take that same autopilot stock here, if I can stay on the road and talk and film. Click, click, and you watch the blue ball. Here we go. There, now we're on autopilot. It's as hard as it is. The car took over steering, and we'll just drive along here. And it looks like we got somebody driving slower than us. I'll change lanes. And it'll change lanes for me automatically. Remember, that works with full self-driving software and enhanced autopilot. It'll actually stay in the lane once I'm here. And to change lanes, I use the directional signals to actually change lanes. That's as hard as it is, and it comes up with a warning that it needs attention. I rotate the wheel ever so slightly here, and that gives me the ability. I'm going to go a little faster here. These slow guys decided that they wanted to go faster now. So we'll get by this truck, and I'll go back to the speed I was going in the first place here. Anyway, there you go. It's as hard as it is. You change lanes again. You just switch lanes by using the directional signals. And we continue down the road on autopilot. Remember, rotational control, it needs you to actually move the wheel right or left ever so slightly. Don't go jerking it, otherwise it'll pop off autopilot. I'll show you how that works. So if I'm on autopilot, let me make it happy first, a little rotation. There you go. Now I'm going to take control, right? I need to, oh man, there's a deer in front. All I do is I rotate the wheel ever so slightly with a little more effort. You can see the autopilot went off. And so now to put it back on, you double click it and we're there. Now I'm going to move over, use the directional signals. Oops. Bad move because two guys are coming on, and then we'll go back over this way now, and there we go. One additional feature you're going to have with autopilot is a following distance, and that's this little control here in the Model X. I rotate it. When I rotate it, you can actually see, oh look, we're in construction, and guess what? We're still on autopilot. How about that? So, again, autopilot, the construction is absolutely no issue. And welcome to Tennessee. We finally got off the interstate. Hallelujah. We're going to make our way to our location where we'll be spending the couple days here, and a little bit more later. Okay. If you like. Way. All right. Trying to navigate here. If you like today's video, go ahead and click the like. And if you would, please subscribe. I'd certainly appreciate it. Thanks for driving along, and in today's video, I hope you learned a little bit about autopilot and that it's not ominous, it's not difficult to use, it's actually a wonderful feature here in the Tesla. Thanks for watching. I'll look for you in tomorrow's video, and take care.